Well, hey, folks, welcome to GLC and welcome to what I'm going to call a prophecy watch. My goodness, Wally Wood, an incredible man. He's been talking about things decades before they have happened. 20-year NASA veteran, author, speaker, extraordinaire, and quite the musician and singer, I should say. How you doing, Wally Wood?
I'm doing great. I can't buy your intros. These are great.
Well, you know, Wally, I tell you, it's easy when it's just telling the truth. And God's done some extraordinary things in you. You created the very first news agency for NASA, 20-year veteran with them. You were talking about digital currency 10 years before the internet even showed up. And yes. What so much of the technology we're seeing right now. But I tell you, Wally, if I would have known about you back in the day, I definitely would have been watching a whole lot more of you because, in my opinion, what you have done and what you're doing is the ultimate prophecy in the news. And it's a very, very real thing. We're watching history unfold. I mean, even the headlines today, you know, the world is seeing such weakness in the White House. And you know, there's a vacuum when there's weakness in leadership. And what do you do when your enemies also have your president on the payroll? Interesting times. But catch us up with you and how you're doing with your ministry and what you're seeing right now.
Well, we're excited about the opening door at GLC. This is something that the Lord has ordered, and he's been working on it behind the scenes, and we're just biding our time, waiting on him to open doors and unveil to us the mysteries he's doing. But we just today taped another program in which I talked about the recent meeting in December of the 15th Provisional World Parliament in New Delhi, India, back in December. And this is the World Parliament as it is preparing to move forward. And according to its design and intention, they intend to replace the United Nations with this World Parliament. So I gave an update report on the things that they did and where it leads to, what it's producing, and its connection to ancient Bible prophecy back in Daniel chapter 2. And this is something that I'm afraid that the church today at large is ignorant of. We are reactionaries. We tend to be reactionaries to the events and the headlines of the day.
Right.
The church is called to know the future from the author of the future, and that's Jesus Christ himself. And we stay away from Bible prophecy. I've heard many pastors say, I won't teach Bible prophecy. I won't allow it in my church. I don't want to scare my congregation. I don't want to lose people from our church or anything of this nature. And yet we are supposed to be the most stable people in the world when it comes to unfolding world events.
Right.
And I said it on your program last time, the more you know, the less you fear, because you know these things are going to have to happen. So the 15th Provisional World Parliament has recently met, and they always come together to amend the new world constitution and to pass legislative laws that will go into effect once they become legal. And you've got over 20 nations involved right now in the new world parliament. So I just did that report, and that will be posted on our YouTube channel here very soon. So I'm prepared to move forward with you. And according to our discussions, you're just going to recycle, re-air the programs that we've already done so that your audience can be brought up to speed on where we are, what to expect next.
You know, Wally, you've always been so ahead of the ball. Folks, you're going to see after this brief catch up, just some things that will blow your mind that as a young man, Wally asked the Lord to show him what things would look like from a cashless society to technology, way ahead of its time, to how the Antichrist operates, even down to a new world flag that you have disclosed a long time ago. And of course, are you still going to churches and talking about this?
Well, of course, COVID has slowed down a lot of those invitations, but we are available as the Lord makes it possible for us to do so. But yeah, we've got programs already set, and we've already put them into practice at our own church here in Houston.
right,
over about a 3 or 4 year period. So we're accustomed to live audiences, and everything that I do is along the multimedia element. So it brings it all up to the front.
Wow. You know, there's so many websites that you operate. I'm amazed that you are able to do that. Folks, if you want real news, you want true news, of course you get that here at GLC, but you also get it straight down the pike, so to speak, from Wally Wood and his various websites. You know, one of the things you're about to see, folks, in the video we're going to show you after this brief catch up is the phrase that you created, Diginomics.
Yes.
And where things are headed. You want to touch on that briefly, Wally?
Well, in 1998, I was asked by my original publisher, who put out my first book on the cashless society,
right,
to write a sequel. And my response was, well, the term cashless society has kind of fallen on hard times, so I'm going to have to pray about this one. And I prayed and asked, you know, Lord, what do we do here? And that's when the word Diginomics popped in my head. And the Lord told me, he says, you're headed into a digital economic system. So wow. We call it Diginomics. So as I checked around all the English-speaking dictionaries, I found that it didn't exist. So I submitted letters to as many English dictionaries as I could find. Letters, not email. Typewriter on paper, okay? Snail mail. And offered the word. And the Merriam-Webster Online Dictionary picked it up in 2007. And gave me credit for coming up with a new word in the English language. If you were to Google the word Diginomics, you'll find that it's got global tracking today. Right. There are courses being taught in Europe, European universities and colleges. There have been at least two books that I'm aware of, one of which written by a couple of economic professors in Spain called Diginomics. You find those on Amazon. Mm-hmm. And there are conferences, workshops, seminars being held everywhere using the term Diginomics. There are a multiplicity of websites that have that word. I chose not to patent the word or trademark it, so it would become a public word. If I had done so, the dictionaries wouldn't pick it up. Right. And I didn't want it to be where it could not be, that would not go worldwide. And so now it is. So Diginomics is the trend that we are in now. Mm-hmm. And that first book, I talked about how people would one day use their Dick Tracy watches, for those of you who are old enough to remember Dick Tracy,
yep,
to make electronic payments at the checkout. And what do we have today? Smartwatches that right. do that very thing. I talked about how there would become a central computer that would one day oversee all of your financial transactions, from the gas pump to the Coke machine to the checkout counter. And I called it CENCOM for central computer, because that was 10 years before the internet went live. And in 1972, nobody knew about the internet. So that's where it all got started. And now it's just a matter of seeing it unfold. And with COVID being the player that it is, it's really caught on. And a cashless system is very much right around the corner. And again, I could go into even more detail on that.
Well, folks, you're about to see this information and more. What an interesting year this is going to be. They're also going to open up from what I understand, in Abu Dhabi,
yes,
the World Religion Center of Islam and mm-hmm. Judaism and mm-hmm. Christianity. And of course, that falls right in line with prophecy as well. But folks, check this out. Wally Wood, it's always good seeing you. And I can't wait to talk to you next time. I know this was a brief catch up, but you're right on the edge of the needle, brother. And we're so thankful.
If you hear the sirens right now, it's an emergency year. Timing is everything.
There you go. There you go. Well, folks, check this out. And Wally, we'll see you at the next Prophecy Watch. Thank you.
Thank you, Brant.
Hello, everyone. I'm Wally Wood, host of the Revelation File. This is a new program on this network, and it's a program that we've developed over the years since 1981, in which we take a look at world events, world trends, world news from a biblical prophetic perspective. I've been in this business since the 70s, really, but we started the Revelation File in 1981 when I had the Christian News Network on national radio, and it has evolved over the years into a subscriber service out to the nation, and now we're on the internet in various different parts. So just to kind of give you a feel for what this is about, let me have you review these two videos that we want you to take a look at right now.
Editor-in-Chief of the Revelation File News Service.
The Antichrist is alive. Technologically, we're there.
Whether he be God or devil, once that man was conceived, his course was set. We're in those days.
Do any of you feel like that you are now on the threshold of the fulfillment of the rest of what's been prophesied in Scripture? I do.
Our focus is on current world trends as they relate to end-time Bible prophecy and the coming of Jesus Christ.
Since 1981, the Revelation File has focused on world trends and how the world is being prepared for the second coming of Christ. And we bring these headlines alive to you. We don't do so much in the way of analysis or commentary. We just bring you the facts as you can find them yourself. And we bring them all together in the context of Bible prophecy and the scriptures having to do with the second coming of Christ.
You're going to see some elements here today that your eye has never seen before. Jesus said that the deception of those days will be so intense that if it were possible, even the very elect will be deceived. If the world is going to be easily deceived by the strongly deceptive, what's going to keep the elect from falling into that same trap?
Our ability to manufacture fraud now exceeds our ability to detect it.
It's easier to make 100,000 believe than just one.
For the Antichrist to rule the world, he must first be able to control the world. And the only way to control the world is technologically.
For more information, visit our website at therevelationfile.com, or you can email us at revfilenews@yahoo.com.
Revelation File got started in 1981 as I was working at a local radio station here in Houston as part of the Christian News Network, which I started in 81. And we were broadcasting to stations across the country the current trends and world news that were pertinent to the end time Bible prophecy fulfillment. And Revelation File started as a 2-minute radio commentary. It's evolved into a nationwide subscription service, and now into these Revelation File forums that we conduct in churches across the land. So it's always been focused on end-time Bible prophecy and the trends in current world events that give address to the coming of Christ and the signs of His coming at the end times. The Revelation File Forum is more or less an evolutionary type of spin-off from the type of news we've been doing for over 30 years. By reason of public demand and request, we've come into the churches, we've put on kind of a Tonight Show type of environment and atmosphere, complete with a stage set, we interview guests. It's a 2-hour program on average. The last hour is given to a main theme, a main topic, and we bring focus to that. And it's built around an animated PowerPoint presentation. And so we have various different subjects that we cover in the Revelation File Forum, and it brings everybody more up to date than just putting out a monthly newsletter, and it gets them involved. The Revelation File Forum covers such topics as, we start with a general overview of what's happening in the world on a broad basis. World conditions, weather conditions, political conditions, economics, and tie them in with the direction of end-time Bible prophecy. After that initial session, we have additional programs that we put on, such as Diginomics, for digital economics. I came up with this word in 1998. It's made its way into the dictionaries and to world forums and conferences on Diginomics. Talking about a cashless society, and we show the trends and the events leading up to a cashless society that will take place in our lifetime. So that's on Diginomics. We also talk about Image of the Beast technology in one of our forums. And we show you the late-breaking advancements in technology, in cinema, in video, that can now replace real actors with computerized replacements. And the talk in Hollywood is that the public will never know. So real is this technology that we can replace a real actor with a computer-generated replacement, and you couldn't tell a difference. The Bible talks about an image of the beast that would come forth. So in one of our forums, we bring focus to this type of technology and give you demonstrations on how this is very real today. And again, showing the time frame in which we're living in today. We also talk about transparency technology. The fact that there's no place to hide. And again, in a one world system under the rule of one man ruling the world, as the Antichrist is going to do, presenting himself to be a god, he's got to show that he can be omnipresent, omnipotent, and omniscient. And this will be accomplished by the advanced technology that's out there today. And we show that evidence in this PowerPoint presentation. So that's a third presentation in our forum series. We like to take these forums on the road and take them to other churches. We'd like to get them, of course, more fully on YouTube and the social networks, because the lateness of the hour is such that much of the news is becoming old fast. And we're advancing very rapidly down this trail toward these things that the Bible prophesies will take place during the time of the Antichrist. So our goal is to reach the world with these messages in hopes of waking people up and realizing the relevancy of end-time Bible prophecy as it pertains to the return of Jesus Christ in our lifetime. That's our introduction into the Revelation File. That gives you a feel for what we're looking to accomplish in these programs. The what you see on the screen right now is our copyright information, because much of what you will see in these series of programs will be full videos, not very long, but full nonetheless, to get the information across to you on the progress and the trends that are happening right now in the world. A lot of people are not really tuned into the depth of what prophecy says about the times that we're living in. It's interesting to note that one of the fastest selling genres of book titles in secular bookstores has to do with end times. And yet people still come away not fully understanding how that relates to what we are presently experiencing, both in this nation and in the world. And so the Revelation File is designed and intended to bring you up to date on these things, to educate you, to inform you, to point to these trends and take it back into scriptures for the end times. I note the fact that Jesus said in Matthew 24 that the generation that saw these specific things that were to occur only one time would not cease to exist until all had been fulfilled, and that included his return. So this is what we've been doing. I've been doing this now since the 70s, and we've done national programs, we've done national tours, and it all stems back to this. These are the evolutionary times. Jesus said, as it was in the days of Noah, so it shall be at his return. So we're in a totally different generation, and especially in the area of technology. Technology is going to make the difference in where we go and how we go forth from here. Again, speaking of the Antichrist, now see, I was 8 years old when I asked the Lord to teach me about the Antichrist, which is kind of an unusual prayer for a little boy to pray. But my dad read to us for the very first time out of the book of Revelation, and he honed in on Revelation 13. And when I heard that, it impressed me. And I went to the Lord. I said, teach me about the Antichrist and cause me to understand how the world would one day worship a man as a god. 10 years later, upon graduating from high school, some more news hit the newspaper that my dad brought to our attention. And I went back to the Lord and I said, I'd like to dedicate the rest of my life to the study, the research, the writing, the reporting of the signs of your return in my lifetime. And from that point on, he kind of carried my career into the media. And I've been in newspaper, magazine, broadcasting, and have met some very important people along the way, and I've learned a lot on the connections between those forces that are bringing about these elements of the Antichrist administration and their connection back to end-time Bible prophecy. So that's what we're hoping to accomplish with this series of reports on this station. The Lord's been very good in fulfilling a promise he gave to me back in the 70s when he told me at that time that he was going to give me my own network. And I didn't know what he meant by that at that time. And when I did have my own national show in the 80s, he told me, he said, I'm opening up a channel by which you'll be able to broadcast to the world at little or no cost to you. And so over the years, especially as we've gotten more involved online, he's provided me what I'm calling the Wood News Group. It begins with wallywoodministries.com. And if you go there, a number of pages, and I take you through several different aspects of this particular ministry that I have, one of which is the Revelation File itself. And that's a separate website, therevelationfile.com. And much of what you're going to see in this series of programs, I'll be gleaning from that website. So again, you owe yourself the opportunity to go and see that website and familiarize yourself with how we have it laid out and what it is that we present there. Another of my websites is Diginomics, diginomicscentral.com. Now, this is a word that the Lord gave to me back in 1998. My first book, entitled Cashless Society, A War Without Money, came out in 1974. And there I talked about how in the next century, which is this century here, we would be living in a more electronic economic system than what we had at the time. And that there would be a central computer. And this computer would oversee every financial transaction that we made. So all of our paychecks would go into this centralized system. If we wanted to make a purchase, we would have to make inquiry. We'd have to make a request of this central computer system to get our money out. I even spoke in this book about gas pumps where you have to put a card in, Coke machines, street vendors. And see, this was 10 years before the internet. The internet didn't come out until 10 years after I wrote this book. And so we didn't know about the internet in 1974. So I called it CENCOM, or Central Computer. And look where we are today. Well, my publisher asked me 25 years later if I would consider writing a sequel. And I gave it some thought and some prayer, and thought about the fact that the term cashless society has kind of fallen on hard times, but the trends were still there. And so that's when the word diginomics, or digital economics, popped in my head. And as I began to look around for it, I found that it didn't exist anywhere. So I wrote to the major dictionaries of this nation and submitted the word. And in 2007, the Merriam-Webster Online Dictionary picked it up and gave me credit for coming up with a new word in the English language, diginomics. And on this site, diginomicscentral.com, we take you to that page in the Webster Dictionary where the word is portrayed. But this came about primarily because a lot of people were starting to pick up on the word. The word was spreading around the world. If you were to do a major online search, you'll find that the word diginomics has got global tracking everywhere. There are even college courses being taught on it in Europe. Conventions, conferences, workshops are being held on the term diginomics now. And so a number of people began to claim origination of the word. And I felt the need to kind of clear away the fog on that, being the grandfather of the word. So I created this website, and now you can go there to find all things having to do with the trends toward an all-electronic, cashless money system that's coming about in our lifetime. So that's the third website, is diginomicscentral.com. Another one is ourtransparentworld.com. The Bible talks about how the Antichrist would declare himself to be God. That means that he has to have the divine attributes of omnipresence, omniscience, and omnipotence to pull it off, to convince the world that he truly is God. Advanced technology will give him that advantage. There's a fourth omni term, if you will, that has come forth in recent years called omnivalence. And that was coined by a law college here in Houston several years ago. For the Antichrist, being a mortal, to declare himself and demonstrate himself to being God, he's got to know what God knows. Superficial, but deceptive nonetheless. With the things that we carry on our bodies today, like the cell phone, online presence,